There's a poem by Robert Burns called Holy Willie's Prayer. And what the poem is about a man who has taken Gavin Hamilton to court. Gavin Hamilton was a treasurer of the church in Mauchline, and he was supposed to collect money for the poor, and this Holy Willie discovered that he was £7 short, and he took him to this Kirk session because he was £7 short. And Gavin Hamilton had a Mr. Aitkin, a lawyer, who came and defended him. And apparently that Gavin Hamilton had been kind and gracious, and because some of the tenants couldn't pay their rent, he'd let them off, and this was why there was a deficit of £7, and not that he'd been taking the money for himself. But Holy Willie, he was so angry, so upset, that he'd lost the case, and Burns had heard him muttering about his loss and complaining to God. And he wrote this poem, Holy Willie's Prayer, which is sanctimonious, self-righteous, and it really takes a dig at the people who are over-religious and think themselves better than others. Although that in the heavens dwell, what as it pleases best thyself, sends yen to heaven and ten to hell, offer thy glory, and no for any good or ill that they have done before thee. I bless and praise thy matchless might, when thousands thou hast left in night, that here I am before thy sight, for gifts and grace, a burning and a shining light to all this place. What was I, or my generation, that I should get sick exaltation? I was deserved most just damnation for broken laws 6,000 years ere my creation through Adam's cause. When from a mother's womb I fell, the might he plunged me deep in hell, to gnash my gums and weep and wail in burning lakes, where damned devils roar and yell, chained to their stakes. Yet here I am, a chosen sample of how thy grace is great and ample. I'm a pillar o' thy temple, strong as a rock, a guide, a buckler, an example to all thy flock. But yet, Lord, confess I must, at times I'm fashed with fleshly lust, and sometimes too in worldly trust, vile self gets in. But thou remembers we're dust, defiled with sin. O Lord, thou kennest we make, thy pardon I sincerely beg. O may it ne'er be a living plague to my dishonour, and I'll never lift a lawless leg again upon her. Besides a father maun avow, we lees his lass 3 times I trow, but Lord, that Friday I was fou when I come near her, or else thou kennest thy servant true would never steer her. Maybe thou lets this fleshly thorn buffet thy servant e'en in morn, lest he o'er proud and high should turn, that he say gifted, if say I hang mon in our bone until thou lift it. God bless thy chosen in this place, for here thou hast a chosen race, but God confound their stubborn face and blast their name, who bring disgrace to their elders and open shame. Lord, mind Gavin Hamilton's deserts. He drinks, he swears, he plays at cards, and has many money talking ears, wee grey and small. Big God's own priest and people's hearts, he steals a wall. And when we chastened him before, thou kenst he bred a sick explore and set the world in a roar, laughing at us. Curse thou his basket and his store, kale and potatoes. Lord, hear my earnest prayer against the presbyterated air. Thy strong right hand, Lord, make it bear upon the heeds. Visit them, Lord, and dinna spare for all their misdeeds. Oh, Lord, my God, that glib tongue aching, my very heart and flesh were quaking to think that we stood there, sweating, shaking, and pished with dread, while he, with hanging head and lip a shaking, held up his head. Lord, in thy day of vengeance triumph, Lord, visit him who would all employ him, and pass not in thy mercy by them, nor hear their prayer, but for thy people's sake, destroy them, and then he spare. But Lord, remember me in mind, with mercies temporal and divine, that I for grace and gear may shine, excelled by name, and all the glory shall be thine. Amen. Amen.